Sure. I wanted to ask you more about the Secretary General's trip. The press coverage is pretty in terms of interpreting what he said and how he's going about things, is pretty almost unanimous in saying that he's trying to send signals that he's going to run for president. So this is a direct quote I want to ask you about. The deputy floor leader of the Minju party said the latest remarks amount to a de facto declaration of a presidential bid. And my question in this light is, I know that Mr. Kim met with South Korean journalists before the trip occurred. And apparently, according to them, he said this is not a political trip. And what I wanted to know is, first, in what capacity did he meet with them? Did he meet with them as Undersecretary General for Disarmament? Did he meet with them? In a sense, some people see it as sort of political work. And so I'm wondering, in the same way that Helen Clark has said that she takes leave to do work to run for SG, was he on the clock? And what in what possible capacity was he speaking?
He's speaking as a UN official who is talking about an official visit by the Secretary General. The Secretary General is here in his capacity as Secretary General. He is doing things such as the Jeju Forum and the DPI NGO conference in his capacity as Secretary General. This is not a trip in a private capacity, and he's made very clear, including to reporters in the Republic of Korea, that he will not be acting in a private capacity until he is done with his duties as Secretary General.
He says that he's been approached by other world leaders about running, that they've offered their support. I mean, I'm sure you've read, this is in Korea Joongang Daily. They quote a number of the reporters that were at this meeting, and he said things well beyond what you're saying from here. And so he can do what he wants, whatever the resolution says. But my question, again, I want to go back to, Mr. Kim's work, was this done in his capacity as Undersecretary General for Disarmament, or as sort of, he used to be Deputy Chief of Staff. Is he still performing that role?
No, he's not. The Deputy Chief of Staff is Patrick Carey. When there are delegations who go on trips, sometimes they speak to reporters about the trip. That's the case with that. The spokespeople do that as well. In this case, he was talking about the trip, and he was trying to make it very clear that this is not a political trip. And that is something that we echo from here.
Yes, one more question, everyone. Just a factual.
One more.
And this is unrelated.
Sure.
It's unrelated, but it's just, the other day I was coming in through the metal detectors, and there was a long student group coming through. It's not what you think I'm going. I'm going somewhere else. Okay. There was a student that had on a Bernie Sanders button.
Yeah.
And the guard said, take it off. No political statements allowed in the UN. And I wanted to know, is that really the case?
Security are told that they're not supposed to be political slogans or political banners brought into the United Nations. I don't frankly know how they enforce it on a case-by-case basis, but the standing rule is that you're not supposed to bring in any sort of political slogans or banners in.
Right. Tell me what the rule is so I can look at whether it applies to a button.
I do think that depends on the individual judgment of the security guard, whether a button counts or not. I am, of course, wearing a button right now for Peacekeepers Day, although presumably that's a nonpartisan button, and hopefully that passes the standard. We shall see when I exit. Some of this depends on judgment calls from the officials on the ground. Have a good afternoon.